Hi everyone, welcome to Think Smart Home. Today I'm going to talk about 5 Docker containers which in my opinion every smart home should have. The way things are heading in 2024, Docker containers are a must for every smart home or a home lab. Using Docker containers, you can self-host many different applications locally, which is great in privacy and overall control perspective. So ditch your expensive subscription services and start self-hosting the services you need. You don't need necessarily a dedicated server to run these containers on as long as you have a NAS. You can use your NAS to host these containers and enhance the functionality of your NAS. Talking about NAS, if you have been watching my videos, you might have noticed I like Synology NAS, and I have been using it extensively in my smart home and eventually in my tutorials too. But if you don't have a Synology NAS, I have created a video on how you can make your old PC a Synology NAS and install DSM on it. I'll share the link to that video down in the description below. You can build your own Synology NAS and host these containers on it, but do make sure you are backing up these containers off your NAS. Back to the video. This video is packed with some wonderful Docker containers, so make sure to stick around all the way until end and hit the subscribe button whenever you get a chance. Alright, let's talk about 5 super useful Docker containers, and I'll mention a bonus container at the end too. Before we start, it's worth mentioning that these containers will be installed using Container Manager on your Synology NAS. If you have not installed Container Manager on your Synology DSM, please do so by going to Package Center and installing it from there. I'll share the tutorial link on how to set up all these containers on your Synology NAS as we go along. Alright, so first one in my list is of course Home Assistant. First of all, what is Home Assistant? Home Assistant is a very powerful open source home automation platform. You can integrate smart devices from different manufacturers under one tiny Docker container and control and automate your smart home using that. Now, you might have 12 smart plugs in your smart home, Philips Hue lights, LG TV, Hill security alarm system, Dahua cameras, Samsung dryer, Unified Dream Machine as your main network gateway, and Apple HomePod as your smart speaker. So does this mean that you'll have to download apps for all these manufacturers to control and automate your smart home? The answer is no. That's because you got Home Assistant, a feature-rich open source and most importantly, locally hosted and managed home automation platform, which will integrate all your smart home devices under one platform. It is empowered by active community of developers who are developing and updating all these integrations. So you definitely need to check out Home Assistant if you are into smart homes. I have created a video on how to install Home Assistant on your Synology NAS as a Docker using Container Manager. I'll leave the link to that video down in the description below. Next one on my list is Uptime Coma. Uptime Coma is an open source self-hosted service. It's an uptime monitoring tool like Uptime Robot. It can monitor all your local services which are running in your home lab or remotely anywhere in the world. It can do a traditional ping to check the status. It can monitor HTTP services and HTTPS services where it has certificate expiry checks too. It can monitor Docker containers. It can monitor TCP services or the port for the uptime. You can also monitor services against a specific keyword. In addition to having a super user-friendly GUI, it has got multiple options to set up notifications to notify or even periodically remind you if any of your services goes down. It also has a feature to create public status pages, which can be shared with anyone publicly. I have created a video on how to install uptime command your Synology NAS using Container Manager. I'll leave the link to the video down in the description below. Next one on my list is Frigate. Frigate is an open source video surveillance system that provides real-time object detection for IP cameras. It is designed to work with Home Assistant to enhance your home security through intelligent video analysis and making it a true smart home. Frigate uses machine learning models to perform real-time object detection on video streams from IP cameras. This includes detecting objects like people, vehicles, and animals. It supports event-based recording. For example, it might record when motion is detected or when a person enters a defined zone. It also supports customizable detection zones, where users can create specific detection zones within the camera field of view. This will help to focus object detection on particular areas and reduce false positives. It's a powerful tool to integrate advanced video surveillance capabilities into your smart home. I have created a 3 video series on how to install and set up Frigate on your Synology NAS. I'll leave the link to that series down in the description below. I hope you are liking this video. Please take some time to give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. Also, hit the bell icon to get notified as I release a new video about smart home automation, storage, and network security. Next container on my list is AdGuard Home. AdGuard Home is a network-wide ad and tracker blocker. It acts as a DNS server that filters out advertisements, trackers, and malicious sites across all the devices connected to your network. It's open source and very easy to set up. It supports encrypted DNS protocols like DNS over HTTPS and DNS over TLS. It has features to block access to certain categories of websites or services, which can be useful for implementing parental control on your network. Again, I'll leave the link to installation video down in the description below. The last one up on my list is Homebridge. Homebridge is an open source software platform that acts as a bridge between Apple HomeKit and a variety of smart home devices that do not natively support Apple HomeKit. By using Homebridge, you can integrate a wide range of smart home devices into your Apple HomeKit ecosystem. This allows you to control them using Apple's Home app on iOS devices or through Siri's voice commands. What makes Homebridge more powerful is its plugin feature. It supports a wide range of plugins that extend this functionality. These are large and active community of developers who are creating and maintaining the plugins for Homebridge. These plugins enable integration with various smart home devices and services. I have created a video on how to install Homebridge on your Synology NAS and then integrate it with Home Assistant. I'll leave the link to that video down in the description below. Alright, these were my 5 picks, which in my opinion are the must-have Docker containers running on your Synology NAS for your smart home. Before I wrap up this video, I want to mention one bonus container here, as I mentioned in the start of the video. The container I want to mention here is the Cloudflare. It's basically a service to set up Cloudflare tunnels to access your home network anywhere in the world without opening any port or poking any holes on your firewall. I have created a detailed video on this. I'll leave the link to that video down in the description below. Alright, that's it for this video. Let me know what you think about these Docker containers. If you want me to create a tutorial on any specific Docker container, let me know in the comments below. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. I'll see you in the next video.